ईईजी और इलेक्ट्रोएन्सेफलोग्राफी। इलेक्ट्रोएन्सेफलोग्राफ इज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच एक्चुअली रिकॉर्ड्स द इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्टिविटी ऑफ ब्रेन फ्रॉम इट्स सरफेस। सरफेस मीन्स स्कैल्प। एंड इट डिड दिस, इट रिकॉर्ड्स दिस इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्टिविटी थ्रू द इलेक्ट्रोड। सो रिकॉर्ड इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोएन्सेफलोग्राफ, while the instrument is known as electroencephalograph, and the whole study of this record is known as electroencephalography. So it is like ECG, its speed is also 25 mm per second, means that stylus that runs on the graph have speed of 25 mm per second. Now it also have leads which are placed on the scalp, and these leads are of two types. First is the unipolar and second is the bipolar. In the unipolar lead, one lead is active while the while the second electrode is known as indifferent electrode, and it records zero potential, and it is usually placed near the ear, while the active electrode is placed on the scalp. The second is the bipolar electrode. Bipolar electrode have positive terminal and the negative terminal. And so this is about the some technical things of things related to the EEG, in which we have studied that EEG is an electroencephalography, and it is an instrument in which there is electrode which we placed on the surface of the brain, and surface is scalp, and what it do, it records the electrical activity of brain. So record is known as electroencephalogram, instrument is known as electroencephalograph, and the whole study is known as electroencephalography, and the speed of the that stylus is known is 25 mm per second. The electrodes are of two type, unipolar and bipolar. Now this instrument records spontaneous recording of the scalp, and what it records, it records action potential that of dendritic end only. Okay, this actually the cerebrum has six layers. And in its fifth layer there is a cortical cell, and this cortical cell, it has axon, and other end has dendritic tree, and in this dendritic tree there are many branches, and these branches goes up to the surface or outermost layer of the cortex, and from this layer the EEG machine records the electrical activity of this dendritic end only. And what it records, it records the graded potential. What is graded potential? Graded potential means excitatory postsynaptic potential minus inhibitory postsynaptic potential. Means this cortical cell have two types of excitation. First, two types of action potential. First is the excitatory type of potential, which excites the other neurons and other ends, other cells also, while other type of potential is negative potential or inhibitory potential, which actually inhibit the production of potential or action potential in other cells. So positive and negative, excitatory and inhibitory types of potential. So this machine actually records the difference between them, and this difference is known as graded potential. Excitatory postsynaptic potential minus inhibitory postsynaptic potential. Now we are heading toward the waves. What it records, this is EEG machine records this action potential of the dendritic end of the brain, and this electrical activity comes in the form of waves. And these waves, for to learn these waves, you just remember the thumb rule of this: lower frequency, the less responsive behavior; higher the frequency, the more active behavior or more arousal state is there. Now different waves of EEG. waves of EEG, to memorize the waves of EEG, you just know the two type of state of our mind. First is the wakefulness and second is the sleep state. Wakefulness also has two types of conditions. First is the wandering mind and second is the focused mind. During wakefulness, we have two types of mind. First is the wandering mind and second is the focused or concentrated mind. And the second condition of brain is the sleep. In this sleep, there is two type of condition: light sleep, that is known as early sleep, or deep sleep, that is known as late sleep. And according to activity of brain, the waves are divided into alpha wave. When there is wandering mind, we are wakeful but our mind is wandering, then we get alpha wave in the EEG. When we are wakeful but we are focused, then we will get beta wave. During sleep, in early sleep or in light sleep, we get theta wave in EEG, and during deep sleep we get delta waves on EEG. Okay, so according to activity of mind, when our mind is very much active, then we will get beta wave. When it is less active, then we will get alpha wave. During light sleep we will get theta wave, and during deep sleep, when there is less activity of brain, we get delta wave. So it is high frequency wave, it is less frequency wave, it is lesser frequency wave, and this is least frequency wave. So according to frequency, the waves are beta, alpha, theta, and delta wave. So here again, one more thumb rule: brain activity is directly proportional to the frequency of EEG waves. Brain activity is directly proportional to the frequency of wave. Now we are studying about the different type of wave, and first we will study the high frequency wave. The most high frequency wave is the beta wave, and it occurs when we are wakeful and we are focused. So when we are wakeful, we are attentive, active, and focused, then we will get more frequency wave, and more frequency wave are known as beta wave, and their frequency is 14 to 30 hertz. While they have less amplitude means their height, they have very less height, only 5 to 10 mv, and actually it is least height we get in the different waves of EEG. So these are the beta waves. They are very frequent. They are very frequent, but they have least amplitude. You can see they are not very much high. They are very short. Okay, so they are high frequency, but they have less amplitude, least amplitude. And where we get, we place electrode in on the skull, on the different area of the skull, and beta wave are very clear in which region? In parietofrontal region. मीन्स फ्रंटल मीन्स फ्रंटल लोब आगे की तरफ सबसे ज़्यादा मिलती हैं. पराइटो फ्रंटल एरिया साइड्स एंड पराइटल एंड फ्रंटल एरिया में सबसे ज़्यादा मिलती हैं, एंड दे आर एक्चुअली ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द रेटिकुलर एक्टिवेटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ अवर ब्रेन. रेटिकुलर सिस्टम एक्टिवेटिंग सिस्टम इज रिलेटेड टू अवर वेकफुल कंडीशन, एंड दे आर ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम हियर ओनली. ओके, नाउ द सेकेंड वेव इज द अल्फा वेव. When alpha wave is again we found in the wakeful condition, but here our mind is wandering, not focused. So eyes are closed when we are relaxed, and we close our eyes, but our mind is still alert. We are conscious, alert, and our mind is wandering. We are thinking here and there, and so we will get here alpha wave, and they are comparatively less frequent than the beta wave. Their frequency is between 8 to 13 hertz. जब हम इसकी frequency देखते हैं beta wave की, तो कितनी? 14 to 30 hertz. जब हम उसके आगे जाते हैं तो ये 8 to 13 hertz इसकी frequency होती, इससे कम होती है. Alpha wave has less frequency in comparison to the beta wave, and it is located in the occipital region. Okay, this is located into occipital region, and its origin is thalamocortex center. Thalamocortex center means when sensory stimulus, first they all the sensory stimulus goes to the thalamus, and from the thalamus it goes to the cortex. So thalamocortical tract is actually the origin of alpha wave, because when we are getting alpha wave, when we are wakeful, and during the wakefulness we are sensitive and we are responsive to all the stimulus. So we get this alpha wave from the thalamocortical center. The